G'day, I'm Simulator Dirk, and welcome to episode 1 of Bus Simulator 2016, take 2. We're going to introduce you to the world of Bus Simulator 2016, and let me tell you, compared to getting OMSI 2 working, or even compared to getting Fernbus up and running, this is certainly the easier one to do. So let's get straight into it, and let's have a look at the very start, where we start up. We're in Sunny Springs, which is a fictional town in Germany, and the whole backstory is that there's a guy called Ben who we'll meet, and he has basically sold this bus company to us. Now he's going to retire and do whatever old bus drivers and old bus company owners do. The whole idea is basically that I'm an owner-operator, and so it's just not a case of let the simulated bus drivers do their thing and that's it. We actually are involved with the running of the company. So let's set the company up and we'll call it Sim. Sim. Erk. Bus. Now it doesn't really matter what you call your company because it doesn't necessarily appear on the side of the buses or anything like that. Okay, so we've set up our company, and as you can see, there's some MAN buses in the game, but we can't get to those yet. We'll talk more about the buses as we go on. And it looks rather cartoonish, especially if you've been watching my Train Simulator episodes. Hell, even LSPDFR, based on the GTA 5 universe, doesn't look this cartoony, based on what we can see. I will save you from doing the tutorial. However, having said that, if you are new to this, play the tutorial. So what we have to do...
Hey, Ben speaking. I'm calling because I thought my experience would be really helpful for your new company. So let's get started. Right now, the city is in dire need of more public transportation. So many people, so few buses. The mayor is giving incentives to new companies that are willing to work with City Hall. Just follow the requirements that you see in this list, and they will provide you with a new bus for the company. Isn't that great? Anyways, now you know what to do. I'll call back when I have more advice for you. Don't let this opportunity pass you by. Oh, right! Almost forgot. I sent you some notes on how to customize your buses. See you later.
So, as you can see at the moment, the game starts in the Suburban District, and that will be the basis of this episode, completing this level in the Suburban District. Once we do that, we get access to the Residential District, and we can join the two districts together. That will be episode number 2. Then, in the third episode, we also gain access to the Modern District, and that's basically as far as I've ever got getting access to those three districts. After the Modern District, we then move up to the Industrial District, and then I presume the Inner City District at the end. But that's way, 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 way into the future. What we have to do first is concentrate on the suburban route, and the route that we can see here from Gentian Street, stopping at St. Paul's Church, Brake Street West, and Crown's Rest Street. The idea is, when we start up a new route, is that I have to drive the route first, and then after I've driven the route, assign a driver to it, and then I drive another route, and so on, and so on. So, I always have buses to drive, and the simulated drivers also have something to drive. You can see there's a bus icon, that's the bus depot. I will give you a look at the bus depot in a minute, but you don't have to go back to the bus depot each time. You don't have to start at the bus depot each time. However, having said that, I'm using the Steam system, and in Steam you do get achievements, and one of those achievements is basically not using auto start or auto finish to set up your bus. So let's look at the objectives and what we'll be working through on this episode. We have to drive the existing route, that's the route in red, from Gentian Street around to Crown Rest Street. We have to give our bus a new paint job, which we'll do. Then we have to extend the existing route by adding more stops to it than driving it. So we'll be driving at least twice, and then customize the bus with decals, and there's a tutorial for that. Do all that, we complete the episode, do all that, we get a free bus for episode number 2. So we click on the route, and then we drive it. So we've only got one bus, so we select it. Later on, I suggest you use Quick Start, and you can also reverse the route if you wish to as well. Keep in mind, we are in Germany, so it's right-hand drive. No, it's left-hand drive, but the bus doors are on the right. That's what I was thinking. And we're on the right-hand side of the road. So we're left-hand drive. Now, I have a Thrustmaster red Ferrari steering wheel, which I use for the driving sections. And you can also use it for this section, although sometimes I use the joystick. We're actually in the bus depot now. So if we have a look around, there's an office. We can see the bus. You know, there's wheels, there's parts. There's a kitchen. Yeah, a little cartoonish, but it gets the job done. So we can go for a walk. And we can go to our bus. So what we can do is open the doors first, and you can walk over to it, use the mouse for this bit, hold the right mouse button, and then click the left mouse button, and it will do what it does, it says on the label. In this case, open the door to the depot. So we can see our bus. Fairly generic bus, the MAN buses come into the game a little bit later on, and it's also just been announced that Mercedes-Benz is also getting on board, with this game as well, so that will come in a later update. See a bit more of the workshop there. So we'll walk over to the front doors, and we'll open them. Maybe I'm on the wrong angle. Sometimes it's very picky about what angle I'm actually on. Sometimes you have to search for the button as well, which I can't find. There we go, we hold the right mouse button, you go over to our spot where the icon is, press the left button, and that will open the doors. Step on our bus, pretty standard two-door bus. There we can walk all around it, and you will actually have to walk through your bus at some stages to deal with customers and that sort of stuff. Press C to enter the cab, so you're now sitting in the cab. So if we look down, there's some things that we have to do. Looks a little bit cartoonish, but again, gets the job done. Hold the right mouse button down, we'll go for the key underneath the steering wheel. Turn it to the right 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Everything's on. So while we're getting the bus set up, we'll turn our headlights on, and we'll turn our interior lights on. And if we turn around, we'd have to leave the cab. but everything's on. Now, you can use a keyboard, you can use a mouse, but it's more on the difficult side. Some of my common functions I've actually got mapped onto my Thrustmaster steering wheel. There are buttons for the indicators, which are actually on the steering wheel that I've got mapped. Left, right, sometimes they don't automatically cancel. Bus stop brake, which uses the right hand Formula One paddle. Main park brake, which is the left paddle. We'll put it back on. You can look around using the arrows on the steering wheel, so you can look to the side, which is what I do most often when the passengers are loading and unloading. You can look left and right for traffic, up and down, make sure you've got your camera in the right spot so you can actually see the navigation display, which is next to the ticket machine. I've got ticketing turned off. I've got enough to do without worrying about selling tickets as well. Some people turn tickets on and you have to issue tickets and make sure you get the right ticket, give them the right change, etc. Using the change machine. Some passengers will complain about the air conditioning, so you can turn the air conditioning on and off. Now with the doors, you can open and close the front doors independently. And you can see the doors are closed. Or you can do the rear doors so you can hear them. Or what I prefer to do, I've actually got them mapped to the right hand button on the steering wheel because it's on the right hand side of the cab. Open. And then close. Now it's not so important at the moment because you've only got two doors, but later on you can get buses with three doors and bendy buses with three doors. So rather than using three separate buttons, it is Europe after all. People get on and off through all the doors, so you can do that. You can also kneel the bus. And to do that, I've got mapped out the bottom button, because kneeling close to the ground, bottom button, and the bus is kneeling. And now the bus is raised, and you'll actually see it if I do it again on your control panel. That's the doors. You won't see that, but you will see the kneeling. That yellow icon, the bus is kneeling. The bus is not kneeling. Now you'll actually lose reputation for driving with a kneeling bus. It is possible. It is possible though. Doors open, you can see the rearview mirror. If I move the camera up, you can see both mirrors. Doors are closed. So that pretty much is our bus, and we have to make sure that we can see our navigation display. It actually won't talk to you. However, the announcements are done automatically for the next stop, so you will hear those. Okie dokie. Park brake off, left paddle. Bus stop brake off, right paddle. And accelerate, and let's go. Driving on the right hand side of the road, and the left hand drive bus. Now sat-nav's telling us to turn to the right. So we can look to the left, nobody coming, look to the right, we'll wait for those vehicles to pass, and there's a police car, so we'll wait for him to pass. Now this guy's here. Right hand indicator on, bus stop brake off, and around we go. And I have problems with corners in that direction turning right. is our first bus stop. Indicator on. Pull up about the line. Bus stop brake on. Kneel the bus. Open the doors. Look at the passengers. So you can see them all in the mirrors. Doors closed. Unkneel the bus. Something is blocking the door. Of course it is. So we'll get out of the cab, press C. We'll go for a walk. And guess what? Somebody is blocking the door. Now you have to be back from her a little bit. And it should come up with an icon if you use your mouse. Ask to move. Right hand mouse button. Tells you what's going on. Left hand past the activator.
I'm sorry, I wasn't aware.
Of course you weren't. Go back to the cab. Back in the cab. Press C. Close the doors again. The rear door only will close. We've unknelt the bus, we can see that because the icon's not there. Left hand indicator on, bus stop brake off, and off we go. Problem solved. Adjust the camera a little bit.
Next stop, St. Paul's Church.
Now there are speed limits in this game, and you can get done the speed cameras. So press T, activate the limiter.
Yes. I checked on my phone, and the map app says we should take this one for the shortest route.
Don't go through the amber lights. That will be basically the same as going for a red light. Bus stop request ding. We have to stop anyway.
That's bad.
The ambulance hit me. So we'll go around the corner. That wasn't my fault. Go around the left. Bus stop coming up. The ambulances don't always overtake you, even if you do pull over. Indicator on. Pull up to the line. Bus stop brake. Kneel the bus.
St. Paul's Church.
Bus Simulator 2016. Okay, I'll check that out.
So ticketing for me is handled automatically. Passengers are loaded, unloaded. Close the doors. Unkneel the bus. Look forward. Left indicator on. Park the bus stop brake off. And off we go. And I have found, both in my experience as a real life train driver and also in this game, if you stick to that routine, most of the time you'll get it right. You will lose reputation points for driving with the doors open. You will lose reputation points for driving while the bus is kneeling. And you do get penalised in money terms if you have accidents. Stop.
before stepping off the bus.
And there's our bus. Before we do any changes to it, we'll hit enter and we'll finish that section. At the end of each drive, you get a ranking. Oh, I don't know if that's going to count as 5 stars, but it's certainly close to it, so let's have a look. Let's explain what's happened in this little bit, because you'll be seeing this screen a lot. Our ticket revenue from Route 1 this week was €2,692. Everything's in euro, because it's a German game in Germany. On the right are our expenses, $250 for an accident, which I don't think was my fault because the ambulance hit me. And bus maintenance and insurance, €750, giving us a balance of almost €1,700. 5 stars, and we went from reputation level 1 to reputation level 2. That will become important later on, because you can only unlock certain buses when you get to certain reputation levels. We have been given some new bus colours and some bus decals, and we can now out a driver, but we won't do that just yet, or will we? No, we're going to customize our bus now. So this is our bus that we have at the moment, the SAS Alpha 36 Golf, a 41-seater, no automatic ramp, it's not a bendy bus, and it costs €90,000 if we were to buy it now, and €750 a week to maintain it. Now we're going to customize it, because that was one of the objectives of the episode. So we are going to pick a color. Now I'm going to pick red, because that's fairly close to Metro Bus, and we'll apply that. And that has done something for our objectives. Now while we're here, we'll be able to give the bus a decal. Now, the difference between a decal and an ad in this game, basically a decal is just a sticker which identifies your bus, and the decals are pretty lame. The ads will actually earn you money. So while we're here, we'll use a decal, we'll choose a slot, and we'll choose a decal, we'll choose the bear paw, we'll use a colour which contrasts with bus, we'll make it orange, we'll make it bigger or smaller, and we'll put it here, we'll move it around a little bit, that's actually probably too big. Let's discard that, choose the slot, choose, okay, we'll just use the hexagon, we'll choose our colour, our location, we'll scale down a little bit, want to say stop for the bus, and I'll apply that. And that automatically has ticked off something else on our list of objectives, and you don't have to do it in order, which I have found out. Now, while we're here, let's earn a bit of money. Let's use an ad. Let's get an ad. We'll choose a slot. And you can see that we haven't unlocked any ads yet, so we can't do that just yet. So we'll exit that, but that's something that can happen. You can, doesn't necessarily matter where you put the ad on the bus, or how good it is, or anything like that. And you make money, passive money off it each week. So we'll exit. We've got one objective to do. We have to extend the current route by adding more stops to it and then driving it. So we'll save our changes to our customization. We'll go to our route editor. And we have our existing route here, Route 1, between Gentian Street and Crown's Rest Street. So we'll edit. It says that we can click on a station to edit the route. So what we will do is that we will go around to Church Street South. It says that we only have to use one. Although for the sake of the exercise, and we'll make the drive a little bit longer. Rake Street East. So both parts of Rake Street are covered. And Church Street. Now it will become important later on to incorporate some more bus stops, but we won't necessarily worry about that at the moment. You don't have to, but I'm going to. So what you can do, we'll continue down Church Street. Whoops. We're going to make this a longer route, but the important thing about it is that we are going to make it a money-making route. So, let me drive. Oops. I don't want to do that. Go back to the existing route for a minute. And we'll unclick. Oh, can we unclick? Ah, we've got to edit first. Okay, so we'll unclick. We'll start at Gentian Street, which we've done. We'll go to Clover Drive. Church Street West, open the drive, St. Paul's Church, Brake Street West, Church Street South, Brake Street East, and Crown's Rest Street. So our Route 1 is a lot bigger. It only misses Garden Lane and West Hill Drive, but we don't have to stop everywhere in this stage. But the more stops we can use now, the easier some of our later tasks will be. So we'll save that, and we'll call it Route 001. And we'll call it, we'll take caps lock off. And we'll call it Suburban. Just to make things a little bit easier for us later on. So we haven't driven this route yet. We have to drive it ourselves before anybody else can. The route will take us 20 minutes. And as we saw, it'll start at Gentian Street, Jada Clover Drive, Church Street West, Lavender Drive, St. Paul's Church, Rake Street West, Church Street South, Rake Street East, Grounds Rest Street, and we'll drive. We've still only got one bus. Now, if we quick start, that means we don't have to start at the depot. We'll start just prior to the first stop, and everything's ready to go for us. So we'll do that, and we'll drive. There are currently many construction sites in the city, and some streets on your route might be jammed. You might need to find an alternative route to be able to reach the bus stops on time. Where have I heard that before? Okay, so we're on a bus now. We're not actually at a bus stop yet. So all the doors are closed. The bus stop brake is on, so we'll turn that off. Indicate, and off we go. Just make sure you press T again. Put your speed limiter on, even though you've just driven. Just a good habit to get into. Now, if there's a later part of the route, you always follow the dark blue. You follow the dark blue bits on your sat nav. The light blue bits might be for later in the route. There goes the bus depot on the right. Here's our first stop on Gentian Street. Customer. Okay, so we'll put both brakes on for that. We'll lower the bus. We'll open the doors and we'll look to the right.
We'll can you extend the ramp, please?
Okay, so now we have to leave the cab and we have to go and assist the guy with the wheelchair. So we'll leave the bus. So when I was playing this last night, this didn't happen at all. So there's the guy. On the right hand button, you'll see under the disabled sign, extend the ramp, left mouse button, animation takes over. The ramp lowers.
You have made my day, sir.
And then you basically reverse the process to stow it. Get on the bus. Back in the cab, and off we go. Close the doors, raise the bus, look forward, adjust our camera, replace both brakes, and we're off. As I said earlier, the indicators don't always auto cancel. Now, on later buses,
next stop, Clover Drive.
On later buses, that will actually happen automatically. You don't have to leave the seat. Bus stop request. Are about because we had the customer in the wheelchair. get on. And so far so good. That wasn't too bad when it comes to construction. At least we didn't have to divert.
Made it on time.
power knows I'm in a 30 or a 60. I've got no idea. Bus with our pretty crappy font and our pretty crappy decal, but there it is anyway. I'll just hit enter. Quick enter.
Congratulations, you did it, kid. What are you waiting for? Go get your new bus.
So let's have a look and see how we did. Okie dokie, so if we have a look at how we went on week 2, our ticket revenue was almost 4,000 euro, almost 1,500 euro in accidents, bus maintenance as per usual, giving us a total of just under 2,000 euro. We're now on reputation level 4, we've got a new bus that we can get, we've got some new decals, and we've got an ad that we can get, and we should have a look at our objectives for the next stage, which is the second part of this episode and the suburban district. The mayor is quite impressed with our current progress. He promises to extend your license to a new district once you have managed to establish a small bus route network. So we've got some objectives. Get your free bus. Establish a new route and drive it. Okay, so that's fairly easy. Hire a driver and assign them to any route that you have already driven. Drive a route while one of your drivers is assigned to a different route. So we can do that fairly easily. So let's get our new bus. As a reward for our success, we have earned a free bus from City Hall.
Nice. It feels great to start expanding, doesn't it? Once you start hiring new people, don't worry about which driver drives which bus. That's done automatically as long as you have available buses for them. Just don't forget to assign your drivers to a route, or else you'll be paying them to scratch their bellies. That's all for now. Don't forget to look at the list of things you should do to keep your company growing. I'll call you back once I have more information for you. See you then, kid.
Okay, so while we're here, let's have a look at our new bus, which is the SAS Bravo 41 Romeo. 34 seats, so it's not as big. It hasn't got a ramp, it's not a bendy bus. 2 tons heavier than the bus that we already have, and it's 3 years newer. Maintenance is a little bit more expensive, and the buying value at the moment is €110,000. So let's customize it. Now, we don't have to put a decal on this, but I want to keep all the buses looking the same, so let's do it. Let's choose a color, red, like the first one. Let's get a decal. And we'll do the same thing at the front. And we'll make it orange, and we'll scale it down a little bit. So, we'll acquire that. Now, to make some money, let's use the ad that we've just got. Again, we choose a slot. We choose ad. I want to scale it up so it looks better than the original ad. We'll put it here. So it looks a bit like an all-over ad. There we go. We'll do that. Now that costs us €2,000 and we get €5,000 per week back on it. So we'll do that one. We'll choose a slot. We can only choose the one at the moment. We'll put that at the back and we'll scale it up. And we'll apply that. And we'll choose a slot and we'll do the same. At the back, scale it up, and we'll apply that. We've got one slot left, but we're not going to worry about that at the moment. So as you can see, our bus looks pretty funky, so we'll apply that and make those changes. Now, we could automatically customize the other buses if the other buses were the same model, but they're not the same model, so we have to go and do that manually. So we'll go and do that for our first bus. We'll customize that. Choose a slot, choose an ad, ramp it up. Spot, and we'll do the same like we just did to our and we'll do our third spot. And there we have it. So now those buses will bring in €1,500 a week in advertising. So we're going to choose, we're going to create a new route. Now for the sake of the exercise, we've got a couple of stops that aren't served. We've got Garden Lane and we've got West Hill Drive. So, in terms of expansion for the future, I'm just going to run a route from Church Street South, so we'll create it. Church Street South to Garden Lane. And that's all we have to do at this stage. We'll save it. Any bus route needs to have a maximum of 3 stops. Sorry, a minimum of 3 stops and a maximum of 20. Okay. So we'll cancel that. We'll, even easier, just for the sake of the exercise, we can always change these routes later. Brake Street West, Crown Street. Well, we're going to create it. Brake Street, Crown Street, and so we've got Rake Street covered. and we'll save it, and we'll rename it, make things a little bit easier for us later on. What we can do at the same time is we can put a driver on Route 1 because we're about to drive Route 2. So let's do that now. We've got some drivers to choose from. Okay, so who have we got? Who are our candidates? Lisa Kennedy. She started 4 different bachelor's degrees. She has some experience as a taxi driver and failed to become a rock star. So I wouldn't rule her out at the moment. Rebecca Roheel has a bachelor's degree in psychology, worked as a conductor for 6 years, is really into progressive folk metal, won't hold that against her. Okie dokie, so that's alright. Johannes Kennedy, again, an apprenticeship as a baker, worked as a conductor for 6 years, and enjoys small talk, so he might be good to have around, he's a bit more expensive. And Cornelia Lesser, completed high school at 22, must take the bus as a child. She's a passionate physicist and she loves Geranius. And she's at 5:20 a week as well. So let's hire Lisa because she does at least have some driving experience. So we'll hire her and we'll put her on to route number 1. And we have completed an objective because we've now got Lisa on Route 1. I'm going to be on Route 2. And that will complete that objective. I've established a new route, Route number 2, and I'm about to drive it. Now, doesn't matter what bus we drive at this stage. One or the other, doesn't matter. Let's drive the new one. Not much difference from the old one. And we'll quick start, and we'll go driving again. This is 18 quick drive, because at the moment I've only made it a short route. A little bit cheating, but hey. Back on, just to be on the safe side.
Crowds Rest Street.
your belongings with you before stepping off the bus.
And we've completed the route.
Look at how you've grown. I read in the news that you've been doing so well that City Hall has now given you access to the residential district. If you keep going like this, you'll get access to the modern district. That means lots of green. But now comes the hard part. You have to establish a bus line network in both the suburban and residential districts to keep the public satisfied.
Let's have a look at how we did in week three. Our ticket revenue from our route that we just drove was pretty good. 1,413 euro. Our revenue from route one, which Lisa is on, 1,154. So pretty good for both of them. I'll probably keep her on that route as much as possible. Our ad revenue from our two buses, 1,500. Our driver's salaries was Lisa's salary, 500 euros, and our bus maintenance and insurance for both buses. We're now at reputation level 5, and we have unlocked different bus colours, which we don't really need. New bus decals, which we don't really need. Now, our important thing is to have a look at the objective which we've got coming up. This is our biggest challenge yet. You need to establish a public transportation network between both districts and keep the passengers satisfied. Have a route with at least 2 bus stops in each of the unlocked districts and drive it at least once. Easy done. Reach a reputation level of 7. Well, we're at 5.5 now, so that's easily done. Have at least 3 routes that you and your drivers... So I had problems with that last night too. Drivers drove last week, and have all of the bus stops be a part of your routes driven by you and your drivers last week. So to recap, we started with route 1, we've got route 2, we've got 2 buses, 1 driver apart from me, and we have this district, the suburban district is the one that we've been in. Now, the next district that we'll be in episode 2, is the residential district. And one thing that I did initially when I first did this scenario was that I forgot about little Village's End right up the top there because it was covered by the main menu. So that wasn't good. And I kept on playing and playing and I'm thinking, why haven't I passed this scenario yet? Why haven't I gone up to the next level? Because I've hit all the green dots, but there was a green dot hiding underneath the dialogue box. So that's what we have to look forward to on the next episode. And then after that, we can hit the modern district. After that, we can hit the industrial. And after that, we can hit the inner city. But that is well and truly down the track. Anyway, I'm Erk. Simulated Erk. That's me. And I will see you next time. Don't forget, stay safe out there. Watch out for Polisi. Not actually sure how they pronounce police in German, but watch out for them anyway. And I will see you next week. Thank you very much for watching.